Listening Library presents What's Inside a Caterpillar Cocoon? And Other Questions About Moths and Butterflies by Rachel Ignotofsky. Read for you by Tashi Thomas. This book is dedicated to the many butterfly preserves and national parks that continue to inspire. Butterflies soar in the sunlight, while moths flutter under the moon and stars. Butterflies and moths have been flying since the dinosaurs roamed the earth. They are found on every continent except Antarctica. Some are big, and some are tiny. Butterflies and moths are two different kinds of insects that are closely related. Can you tell how they are similar? Both can fly. Both have antennae. Butterflies and moths are both the only insects with scaly wings. Another way that they are alike is that both start as wingless, wiggly caterpillars. Their change is dramatic and mysterious. How does this grow wings? Moths and butterflies have four different life stages. Number one, an egg. Number two, a caterpillar. Number three, a pupa. Inside a moth's cocoon, or as a butterfly chrysalis. Number four, and as an adult. The transformation from egg to adult is called metamorphosis. But why do caterpillars change? Why are these insects important? What's inside a cocoon? Science will help us answer those questions. Let's take a closer look, starting with an egg on a leaf. Crunch, munch, the baby caterpillar eats its way out of the egg.
I'm hungry! Yum!
Caterpillars are also called larvae.
A caterpillar hatches on a host plant. Its leaves make the perfect meal. As the caterpillar grows, its hard skin stays the same size.
Munch!
With each growth spurt, the old skin splits.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.